Hello. Welcome. You were referred to me by your primary care doctor. And she mentioned that there might be something strange going on with your eyes, okay? Yes. She seemed to detect some type of abnormality going on, perhaps below the surface. Sure, I understand. You probably go to a regular eye doctor and they never find anything weird, right? Yes. Well, I'm not really an eye doctor. I'm more of a doctor that specializes in abnormal things that might be going on below the surface. Can be anything. Eyes, body, and so on. Okay. It was not anything bad. Your doctor just seemed that you might be seeing things differently, right? You might be having a different way of seeing that's what we wouldn't consider normal. It's not a bad thing. And if we find something, it's probably a good thing, and if we don't find anything, it's also probably a good thing, so there's really no harm in this whole test today, okay? Alright, well, now that you can relax and not be worried that something's wrong, I'm gonna get started, okay? So, like usual, I would just like to ask you a couple basic questions about your eyes, okay? Okay. So, who's your regular eye doctor? Or who do you go to? You know, America's Best, Lens Crafters, what are the other ones? Pearle Vision? Okay. And do you usually see the same person there? Okay. So, what location do you go to? Okay. Yes. Because I might want to try to get some of your records and take a look at them, if that would be okay with you. Of course, need your authorization. That'd be fine? Okay. Alright, currently, do you experience any floaters? Fine. How about difficulties at night? Some people can struggle with like driving, you know, like the lights coming at them, affecting them in a certain way. Interesting. Okay. So you sort of are experiencing some type of color burst when you have lights flashing at you at night. Okay. Interesting. No, it's interesting because most people don't have that sort of experience. It's not a bad thing, though. It's what we're sort of testing for. And when was the last time you had your color vision tested? Sure. Yes, it's usually one of those things they do when you're younger and then they decide that you are have color blindness or you're normal and that's it. Okay. remember the last time that your eyes were dilated? Okay, it's been a little bit. That's usually for checking for abnormalities in the eye. No, we actually won't have to dilate your eyes today. Depending on if we find anything, maybe we'll want to dilate them in a future visit. How's your general health? Do you feel well? Okay. Actually, your doctor indicated that you were below weight a little bit. Yes, but body mass wise, if we're just looking at you, you look normal, but you're underweight. Is there anything going on with that? I mean, you can always talk to us doctors if you're having issues with food. Okay. Alright. You know, it could be related to what's going on with your eyes, so. But we won't talk about that quite. We want to see what's going on up here first. Okay. Alright. So, that's sort of all I need to know for now. First thing I want to do is take a look into your eyes. See if I can't spot anything. So, I'm going to be pointing a bright light and don't look at the light, you don't have to look at it. It's just for me to get a better look, okay? Right, okay. Just call this light. Take a look. Question. Have you ever seen how in photos some people's eyes turn red when the flash hits their eye at night? You know what I'm talking about? Has that ever happened to you? You know, in photographs when somebody takes a picture of you at night. Has there ever seen a red eye? I thought so. It's never happened to you before. I don't have the proper imaging resource to really look back into your eye, but okay. You know, it could be that you have a longer eyeball, So the retina is farther back. Sure. You know what? Let me explain to you. Let's have this trusty eyeball. And we can sort of take a look. So, what I'm looking for is everyone has this retina at the back of their eye, right? See it right here. And the reason that at night when you take a picture of someone and you see that red in their pupil is because the flash is going through the lens here and reflecting off of the retina and actually showing on camera, right? And the retina is usually red. It's full of blood vessels and it's what picks up the image on the eye and translates it into a nerve impulse, which is sent through the optic nerve into the brain. Your eye, I'm not seeing that retina at the back. It's possible that you have a very long eyeball, so that the retina is much farther back, so we're not able to see it as easily. Oh yeah, this white part is called the sclera, and it really just provides this structure to the eye. And a spot for these muscles to hold on to. The front, we have the pupil, which is the hole that the iris makes and opens and closes to let in more light to shine onto the lens. And everybody's eyes is covered and protected by the cornea, which is clear. You can't really see it. Whole back jelly is called the vitreous humor, and it really just provides that ball-like structure to the eye. So we're trying to see what's going on with you, see if there's some sort of anatomical difference with your eye, which it's appearing that there is. Now, I like to do just a standard eye exam on you with the charts behind me, okay? So let's do that. First, I'm going to dim the lights off so you could see it a little bit better, okay? All right. Okay, that should be a little bit better. You can see it fine. Alright, fantastic. So, we're going to start at this chart on the left, the E at the top. We want you to start at line 2. Okay. And what color is that? We're gonna go to line 3. And this one right there. Okay. And what color does that look like to you? Good. Alright, then to line 4. Good job. And what colors do you see in that line? Fantastic. Look at you go. Alright, so how about for line 5? What do you see? Can you see what colors are in line 5? Good job. How about line 6? Great. And can you see those colors? Can you keep reading down any farther? Oh, what's the farthest you can see? Wow. Wow. Okay. Pivot over here, and now we're going to be using the chart on the right, okay? And taking a look at that one, this is a pictorial chart, as you can tell, and I want you to just tell me what images you see and what color they are. We'll start at the topmost, okay? Right. Next one. Good. Keep going. Good job. Yeah, you can keep going. Okay. Okay. Sure, go ahead, keep going if you can. Right. Okay. Can you see the bottommost row? Bottommost row doesn't have any colors. What colors are you seeing? Okay. Keep going, sure. Okay, well. Okay. Interesting. All right. Well, you did great. You have an excellent, incredible vision. In fact, you're not even supposed to be able to see the bottom rows of either of them. I'm very, very impressed. Really amazing vision. Okay. So, let me turn the lights back up and we'll do some more testing. Okay. Okay. So, let's get on to a couple other tests here that I have. I have right here. with me. The color deficiency test is supposed to test if you have any color vision problems. Since you are indicating to see some sort of different colors. Yeah. So I just want to double check what's going on with that. Alright. So I'm going to be showing you a couple of images, and I want you to tell me which number you see in the image. It's very simple, okay? To make it a little more complicated, I want you to hold this over an eye, and I'll tell you which eye to do, okay? Alright, so I'm going to give you this. There you go. Okay, so first, I want you to cover your left eye. Good. And I want you to just look at the image that I'm showing you, okay? And tell me which number you see. Great. And which number do you see here? Okay. All right. How about this one? Great. And here. Great. How about this one? Fantastic. And another one. Here. Good job. And how about here? Good. There's another one. Great. And what do you see here? Okay. Can you, by any chance, trace your finger along some lines for me? Good job. And same thing with this one. Trace your finger along some lines. Good. Good job. And what do you see here? Good. And this one? Great. And I want you to trace on this one. Good job. And how about this one? What do you see? Interesting. Okay, okay. Okay. And can you trace on this one? Good job. And trace on this one as well. Good job. Also this one. Good. One last one to trace. Good job. Fantastic. All right. Now we're going to switch eyes. Right? Cover up your right eye for me. This one. Good job. Okay, so let's get onto this side. I'm gonna make sure that that eye is okay. So, which number do you see? Good. What number do you see here? About here. Good job. Okay. Now this one. Right here. Okay. Next one. And what number do you see here? Great. About here. Great. And do you see anything here? You can. Can you maybe trace some lines for me? Okay, good job. Same thing here. Tell me if you see anything. And if you can you trace some lines? Great. How about, what do you see here? Good job. Here. Trace some lines here for me. Good job. What do you see here? For me. Good job. And same thing here. Can you trace some lines? And then again, trace these lines. Great. Trace these lines as well. One last one. Yep, Jason for me. Okay, I can take that, thanks. Great job, your color vision is excellent, it's perfect. On you, and it's going to be with the light again pointing into your eyes, but I'm going to be testing some different colors, okay? I might have kind of a funny question, if you don't mind me asking. What color is my lab coat? Wow, okay. What color? Interesting. Okay, let's do this test. I don't even think we need to do it, but I'm gonna dim the lights again and shine a colored light. Using a light, slightly different colors, and just testing. It's a little bit more dim light, so you don't have to worry about looking at it too much, but try not to look directly at it for any length of time because it's not good for the eye, okay? Alright, so let's. Now I want you to just follow the light. I'm going to be moving it down across, and I just want you to follow it with your eyes. Don't move your head or anything, just with your eyes, okay? Sit a little bit farther back, that way you can follow as much as can. Good job. Let me switch to a different color now. Okay. Now I'm going to look. Very closely into your eye with this light. Seeing what we see. I might react. Again, I just want you to follow the light with your eyes. Okay. So start here in the center. Great tracking. You're doing really, really well. Come towards you. Very close. And pull away like that. I'm gonna try that again. I'm gonna come towards you and look, and then pull away very quickly. Okay, good job. Okay, now for a different color. Look right at my nose. Okay, I'm just gonna come very close. Okay, good job. Alright, again, follow the light for me. Good job. Okay. And come close. And then go far away. Okay. You're doing so well. And this is actually really helpful. I'm glad I decided to do this test. Okay. Next color. Such an interesting case. Yep, just follow. You know the drill by now. Right in my nose for me. Okay. Wow. Yep, and my nose. Now follow this one for me. Coming close, very close, and then moving away. I bet you're dying to know what's going on. I'm sorry if I haven't been very explanatory. That's my fault. I get caught up in everything. Have you ever learned about how we see color? Maybe in school, or maybe in your own personal quest for knowledge? Well, I'll just give you a refresher. So, in our eyes, there are rods and cones. Rods are responsible for nighttime vision, okay? And cones are responsible for color vision. And normal, everyday humans, pretty much everyone on this entire planet, has three cones: red, green, and blue. Right? And that's how we see all these beautiful colors. Some people, very, very rare, have four cones, and they can see a little bit farther into the UV range. You, on the other hand, you might have as many as 15 or 20. I can't tell, but you have more cones than the average person. A lot more. And that might indicate something about you. And I would really, really, really love if you would join me for another round of testing. Not here. I'm someone who moves around a lot. I don't stay in the same office for very long. So let me tell you what. I'm going to let you think about it. And I'm going to give you a phone number to call. And you need to decide by 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. Okay? No other time. You must call at 10 a.m. Not a minute too soon, not a minute late, okay? You won't be able to get in contact with me again after that, I apologize, but I cannot offer you any other contact information. Nope, the phone won't answer if you call at a different time. And I won't be here after today. Like I said, I move around a lot. Here's the phone number and the time at which you must call, okay? If you decide to call, then be prepared for another round of testing at a different facility with some more advanced equipment, because I just don't have the capabilities here, okay? Oh, it is all free of charge. No need to worry about that. Otherwise, if you want to go back to your regular life and just enjoy her wonderful color vision, then I accept that as well. So think about your decision very carefully, okay? Thank you so much for coming in. And please tell your doctor hi from me, okay? She's one of my favorites, and she's really great. You're lucky to have her, okay? All right. Bye-bye. Maybe talk to you tomorrow.